Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part one of equations and graphs of ellipses. We're going to talk about ellipses centered at the origin. And in this video, we graph the following ellipse that has this equation. All right, we're going to go over the basics of ellipses, not everything about ellipses and how they're defined necessarily, but just about their equations and their graphs. So the equation of an ellipse centered at the origin is of the form that you see right here, x squared over a squared plus y squared over b squared equals 1. Now, a and b are just numbers and they can't be zero. Okay, so that's one important thing. So let's just start off with what if A and B were the same number? So let's see, what would happen if I had written this equation? How would I graph x squared over 2 squared plus y squared over 2 squared equals 1, for instance? Well, really, that's the same thing as saying x squared over 4 plus y squared over 4 equals 1. And then you might notice that if you multiplied both sides by the least common denominator of 4, in other words, each term gets multiplied by 4. 4 times the first term is x squared, 4 times the second term is y squared, and 4 times 1 is 4. And that you might recognize is the equation of a circle. So the first thing you might think is, wait a minute, what happened here? I was talking about an ellipse and I get an equation of a circle. This is the equation of a circle with radius 2. Right? Because 4 is 2 squared. So if I were going to graph it, we know the center is 0, 0. We would just go 2 spaces in each direction. And we would have this circle. So the first thing I want you to realize is there's something about this equation of ellipse and the equation of a circle that's kind of similar, right? The difference is when A and B are different numbers, what's going to go on? So if these are really the same number and you put it in this form, hopefully you see that you could directly write that as an equation of a circle and graph it. So we want to see what happens if these are different numbers. So let's try that. All right, so how would we graph x squared over 25 plus y squared over 9 equals 1? The first thing I want you to notice is our little trick of just multiplying by the least common denominator will not give us a circle. The least common denominator is 25 times 9, and you would get a different coefficient for your x and y. So this is not going to be a circle. So let's say to graph something, if you don't know what it looks like, what you could do is just make a table of ordered pairs. And one simple thing to do is think about what the x and y intercepts are. So how would we get the x intercepts? Remember, you're going to let y equal 0 in the equation. So if I put in 0 for y in this equation, I'll get x squared over 25. This is going to be plus 0, right? If I put in 0 squared. So this term basically is going to go away. I'll have x squared over 25 equals 1. Now, we could multiply both sides by 25. And that'll give us x squared equals 25. And then we could take the square roots of both sides, so that we get x is plus or minus 5. At least that's one way to solve this equation, x squared equals 25. You could also subtract 25 from both sides, factor it, set each factor to equal to 0. You're still going to get x is plus or minus 5. So what are our x-intercepts going to be? Well, when I put in 0 for y, x could be 5 or x could be negative 5. So I have 5, 0, and I have negative 5, 0. So those will be our x-intercepts. Now, why don't you put the video on pause and try to figure out what the y-intercepts are? You're going to do a similar thing. You want to get the y-intercepts, so you're going to, in this equation up here, you're going to let x equal 0 and then figure out what the y-intercepts are. All right, did you do it? Okay, so if you do this, if you let x equal 0, what's going to happen is this first term, x squared over 25, will pretty much disappear, and you'll get y squared over 9 equals 1. And then when you multiply both sides by 9, you'll get y squared as 9. This time, you should have got y equals plus or minus 3. So your y-intercepts are, well, you let x equal 0. So it was 0, 3, and the other one was 0, negative 3. So look back up here at our original equation. We found four ordered pairs, the x and y intercepts, for this equation, x squared over 25 plus y squared over 9 equals 1. Let's graph those four ordered pairs. All right, so here's our equation. Here are our ordered pairs. I just put it in a table, x and y, and so let's graph those. We have 5, 0. That'll be right here. And we have negative 5, 0. We've got 0, 3. And we have 0, negative 3. Well, that's four ordered pairs, so that really doesn't tell us exactly what this is going to look like. But you could plug in some other values for x and y and see what you get. So let's plug in some more values. Like, I wonder what it is when, you know, x is, you know, 3. I wonder what happens if you plug in 3 for x. So I go back up to this original equation. I could put in 3 for x. So that gives you 9 25ths plus y squared over 9 equals 1. All right, so we would have to solve this equation. So I could subtract 9 25ths from both sides, or I can multiply both sides by the least common denominator. Lots of ways to, actually I'm going to do that on the next page. Whoops. All right, so we have this equation. So how could we solve this? How about if I just subtract 9 25ths from both sides? I have y squared over 9. Now 1 minus 9 25ths is the same thing as 25 25ths minus 9 25ths. So I have y squared over 9 equals 16 25ths. And then I can multiply both sides by 9 so that I have 2, and let's see, sorry, that's 144. 16 times 9 is 144 25ths. So y, taking the square root of both sides, this is square root of 144 is 12, and square root of 25 is 5. So that's the same thing as plus or minus 2 and 2 fifths. All right, so remember, I plugged in x equals 3, right? And I got 2 and 2 fifths, plus or minus. So let's go back and plug that in. So I got 2 and 2 fifths, and I also got negative 2 and 2 fifths when I plugged in 3. So let's see, if I go over 3, it says go up 2 and 2 fifths. All right, it's about right here. And there's this other one down here. As it turns out, when you plug in negative 3, the same thing will happen, because when you square the x up here, everything will come out the same. So I'm also going to get these ordered pairs over here, negative 3, 2 and 2 fifths, etc. And you could do a whole bunch of ordered pairs till you get enough dots. But what's going to happen is you get actually this, whoops, squished circle. Let's try graphing this again. All right, and this is what an ellipse looks like. It's kind of an oval, right? So when these denominators here in this form are different numbers, it has an oval shape. It's not going to be a circle. Okay, and usually A circle is kind of a special looking ellipse. Usually when we talk about an ellipse, we mean it will look oval looking most of the time, right? All right, so can you see an easy way to maybe get this without putting in all these ordered pairs? Let's regroup here. So we look at our original equation, right? X squared over 25 plus y squared over 9 equals 1. And this is in standard form, okay? That's the standard form of an ellipse. And it's because it actually helps us figure out how to draw the ellipse. Here's the idea. Standard form is often written so that you could take the number in each denominator and write as something squared. So that you could think of that as x squared over 5 squared plus y squared over 3 squared equals 1. And notice that the x-intercepts are what? The x-intercepts are plus or minus 5, and the y-intercepts were plus or minus 3. See that denominator here, the 5 squared? That tells you where on the x-axis to put the intercepts. 5 and negative 5, and then the denominator under the y, since it's 3 squared, it'll be plus or minus 3. And that's the simple way to draw the ellipse. You'll put those four ordered pairs, don't worry about all these ones in the middle, and you're just sketching it, right? If you wanted to get a really good sketch, you would have to like try a lot of other numbers. Like we figured out 3, 2, and 2/5. And you could plug in all sorts of ordered pairs and get a whole bunch of little dots, so you might get a little bit nicer looking ellipse. That's what a graphing calculator would do for you. So that's how we graph an ellipse of this form. So if it's centered at the origin and we have it in this form, it's easy to see what the x and y intercepts are. So let's write this out in a nice way. All right, let's summarize. An ellipse centered at the origin in standard form is written as x squared over a squared plus y squared over b squared equals 1. Now, sometimes if this is like 3 squared, you'll just see people write the number 9. That really doesn't matter. It's up to you whether you want to write it as 3 squared or 9. The x-intercepts are a0 and negative a0. In other words, they cross the x-axis at a and negative a. The y-intercepts are 0b and 0, negative b, which means crosses the y-axis at b and negative b. And these points here are called the vertices of the ellipse. And just note, when a and b are the same, it's really just a circle of radius a, which of course is the same thing as radius b, since a and b are the same thing. So we are only talking about an ellipse centered at the origin right now, and we've only done one in standard form. And I'm not talking about how, there's a lot more to ellipses than this. This is just sort of the basics of understanding what the equation of an ellipse looks like and how you would graph them, write the intercepts, which are the vertices in this case. So we'll do a few more problems. Also, we'll do some problems that aren't already in this form. So we'll figure out how to put it in standard form, etc., in the next videos. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.